A very good evening to everyone. We welcome you to the webinar on TCS NQT, your students' gateway to thousands of top jobs in multiple corporates. We will have the live session for 1 hour, out of which we will have a Q&A session towards the end for about 15-20 minutes. You can post your questions with your name and institute name in the chat window. All the participants will be on mute. Now, today we have Mr. Manivannan Ranganathan, who is the program director for TCS NQT. He is currently driving the TCS National Qualified Test Initiative for TCS Business Unit, and he has rich experience in the IT sector with more than 28 years of work experience, out of which the last 24 years are with TCS. He played a key role in setting up the automation platform for 100 plus educational institutions across India. Mani has also handled delivery, client relationship management, and business development for many TCS insurance clients in US and India. Welcome to this live session, Mani. Over to you now.
Thank you, Himshadra. I hope I'm audible.
Yes.
To all the educators today, thank you and a warm welcome to all of you. It was nice that you could take some time out from your busy schedule and join with me today to know more about what TCS National Qualifier Test is, what is that we have thought through in terms of how it can help you and your students to benefit in a large way, and set of key actions that you could take to help your institutions. So that's what we will do today, maybe about 40 minutes, as Shubhra said, and then have a Q&A towards the end. This National Qualifier Test is a tool that we have built to enhance the employability of our students and thereby transform your placement process through that approach. Now, what is NQT? It is a test that is conducted nationwide and assesses students' ability on multiple dimensions of cognitive, industry, and subject areas and gives them a score. Basically, assess students' knowledge and give a score, like an employability score. And using that, they can apply to different corporates for a job role that fits them based on their aspirations, based on their eligibility, based on the NQT performance. Now, the way we have done this is a model similar to SAT exam in the US, where the admission to colleges are based on the score. And the candidates get a score based on which they apply to different colleges. Same way here, our vision is that we test the candidate on multiple areas, and then based on the scores, they're able to get recognition in a corporate and get a job. That corporate could be TCS and Tata Group companies and other corporates that we're tying up with. We'll talk about it towards the second half of my discussion. And as a product, when we started looking at employability and fresher hiring specifically, we spoke to a lot of corporates in terms of what is that they look for when hiring a fresher, because they do not have an in-depth knowledge or in-depth experience on a particular job role that they are looking for. Right? So it's not an experienced professional hiring, but a fresher hiring. So we wanted to ask in terms of how do they evaluate, how do they select, how do they shortlist. The common theme that came through is a cognitive ability. Almost every corporate said that we measure the student's ability and cognitive knowledge, and based on that, we shortlist and take them for an interview process. So we created the basic foundation for our score, which is the cognitive score, right? That tests on the verbal ability, numerical ability, reasoning ability of the candidate. These are not something that they learn in colleges. These are more 10th standard kind of knowledge in terms of the reasoning and numerical knowledge they carry, which means that it is more of an innate cognitive ability the student possesses, and that is something that could develop over a period of time, but not necessarily the knowledge they're gaining through the graduation itself. Graduation summative exam scores are different, and these are the cognitive scores. Right? The second common factor that came is the psychometric profile. Almost every corporate said that depending on the job role, they do look for certain assessment of their psychometric profile in terms of a sales role or a a front office clerk role or a shop floor worker role or a retail executive kind of role. So in almost every place we look at, the common factor that came is the psychometric profile. So that also we added as an additional test for NQT. The third feedback that came is in terms of the industry connect. From a corporate knowledge perspective, how do we add additional industry and subject areas into their knowledge, right? So many of the corporates are looking for industry connect. So we added two more elements to it, which is the industry NQT score and subject NQT score. Industry NQT score focuses on a basic understanding of an industry. It could be, for example, information technology, manufacturing, automotive, pharma, retail. So it is about a basic understanding of the candidate's ability on a particular chosen industry. The next level is the subject NQT. So this is where the specialization or deep knowledge of a subject comes in. For example, in IT, we have a programming subject NQT. So it tests on candidate's ability on programming concepts and hands-on programming. We have created for on the banking side on financial markets and services. So it tests on the ability on the basic concepts of the financial services market. So someone who is wanting to make a career in IT could choose subjects that are related to IT and get a specialization on them. Someone is interested in a banking career could focus on banking related subjects and get some expertise on that. As of today, we have created variants on banking and IT, and we will continue to add more industry and subjects variants into this. Right? Now, from a positioning standpoint, right? A candidate who is able to certify themselves on additional industry and subject areas definitely will have a better weightage, better visibility, better, initiative on their side to pick up knowledge that is relevant to a particular industry. Imagine someone going for an IT job or a banking job, and they're able to tell that these are some of the capabilities that I've certified myself for compared to someone who doesn't have it. So that the whole intent is to create more certification programs so that the students can certify themselves on these areas, and when they go and approach a corporate for a job, the corporate is able to evaluate them with more finesse. Now let us look at some more aspects of the exam itself. We have made this exam as a generic exam across all degrees. Anyone who is doing UG, PG, diploma of any degree, like say engineering or arts or commerce or science, can write this. And anyone who's studying in pre-final or final year also can write it. Now, where does this come in, right? In case they're looking for a career towards the end of the final year, they have to have some ability to understand where do they stand. Are they really good at all these subjects and cognitive skills? Do they need to learn something more to make themselves better? So having an early peek into their ability will help them understand the strengths and position themselves better when they're actually taking the key exam next year when they're looking for a job. While there are industry and subject variants we have created, the cognitive ability itself is industry agnostic. And someone who is having a cognitive score or NQT score can apply to any job, because as I said at the beginning, almost every corporate is looking for a cognitive ability test. We have made this test as more of a score-based concept and not a pass or a fail. What it means is that anyone who writes this gets a score. Using that score, they can apply for a job. It's up to the corporate to tell whether the score is sufficient for their hiring. For the job role they're hiring, is it sufficient? So the corporate and the job role decides the usefulness or the employability readiness of the candidate. And when they do that for a few months, if they realize that they're able to get a job, excellent, good for them. In case they don't get shortlisted, that's an indication that they may have to improve their score. Considering the current pandemic situation, we are doing these exams in an in-center mode and remote mode. The candidate will be able to apply for this at the time of filling the NQT application. We have made the score valid for 2 years, which means that if there is a candidate who is writing this test as a third year or a pre-final year candidate, if he or she has scored well, they can use it for next 2 years to get a job. We are not saying that it is valid for 3 months or 6 months or 1 year. We give longer longevity so that the score can be used for a job listing portal for a longer time. Now, there is an upcoming NQT that we are doing on May 1st and 13th. The registration closes in about a week's time. So I would encourage people who are participating in this call to understand this product better and see how you can make it relevant for you and your institutions and participate in it. Now, we have created multiple variants. Like I talked about, we have created variants in IT and banking as of now. And given that there is a set of skills these industries look for, we have created some good bundles as well so that the students can buy this bundle and get multiple products subscribed as part of that. Right? So one is a IT career pack that focuses on cognitive, psychometric, and programming. And another is a BFS career readiness pack that focuses on cognitive, psychometric, and financial markets and services. Now, the colleges that are part of this webinar, if you're buying this as a distributor, right, where you can buy this in bulk, then you can actually buy multiple subscription codes or license codes and give it to your students for buying this. So they don't have to pay at the time of purchase. So it is like an activation model. So when you register yourself as a distributor and pay in bulk, then you get a lot of license codes based on the number of products you have purchased. And then these license codes can be shared with the students for them to register. And that time the students do not have to make a payment. Now, what has happened so far? Right. So the TCS NQT concept itself started in October 2020. In the form of an employability test. TCS NQT had happened in the past as well, like 2018 and 19. This was predominantly done as a TCS selection test only. From 2020 onwards, we have created this as an employability test design, which means that a student who is taking this test can apply to TCS and many other corporates that we are partnering with. That is a difference from October onwards. So far, 5.5 lakh students have taken this exam and they've been represented from 2000 plus colleges. And as of today, we have partnered with 100 plus corporates who recognize this NQT score and are willing to hire based on that. Like we talked about those two packs that I created. These are some representative companies that have partnered with us, and our vision is to create at least 1,000 by end of this year across different segments. So these you can see are in IT, manufacturing, maybe retail, right? So there are some Tata Group companies as well as part of this. And our plan is to make it the single largest portal where job seekers who are freshers looking for a job and corporates who are looking to hire fresh talent can come to this portal and meet their expectations. Candidates that gets hired, and for a corporate, a fresher is made available. Now, from a corporate perspective, while they might have different avenues already, the difference we are bringing to them is that they are having pre-certified candidates in the areas of cognitive skills, industry and domain skills. And that is a differentiator for them to pick and choose the candidates that are relevant for them. Also, while the TCS NQT as an employability product is a paid product, for the corporate, we have made it free so that when they hire, they do not have to pay TCS any money for using the platform. So that way they hire more and more people, and it helps the students and institutions to place their students. Now, as a candidate, if someone has taken this test, as I said, they'll get a score. Now, with the score, they can apply to a job listing portal. It is part of TCS iON. So we have created a job listing portal where they can go and complete their full detail, like a digital profile, in terms of their college project, the kind of education qualifications, their key skills that they possess, any certifications that they've done in the TCS platform or outside the TCS platform, doesn't matter. Certain certifications that they carry can be included as part of their digital resume, right? Now, along with the NQT score, in the same platform, as I said, I'm inviting corporates to come and register, where I'm telling the corporates that there is a large pool of students certified in cognitive subject industry skills. Why don't you look at them? So we register, we invite them to register to this portal. Now they post jobs. Now, as and when they post jobs, these jobs are visible to students in terms of the company, the role, the location, the type of eligibility criterion, skill sets required, certifications required, all that is visible in the job description itself. Based on that, if the student feels this is in alignment with my career choice and my eligibility and my capability, they can apply for this job. Then based on the number of candidates applied and their eligibility criteria, a corporate will shortlist. They will do an interview as well. Today, we have a provision for doing online interview. Some corporates might call for an in-person as well. It's up to the corporate. Then post that, they select the candidate. So this is how the whole hiring process works, where the corporates post jobs and based on applications, hire candidates. So in summary, if you look at it, right, what does NQT do as a set of key value parameters? TCS is hiring based on NQT score, right? So if someone is aspiring for a job or a career in TCS, it is mandatory for them to write the NQT cognitive paper and also subject NQT programming paper. For any IT job, both are mandatory. For a BPO job in TCS, only cognitive skill is sufficient. Programming is not required for a BPO job. Like I said, not only TCS, we are partnering with more corporates. So from a candidate perspective, the number of opportunities is multifold as of today, and will keep increasing once they get a score and register themselves in the job listing portal. A broader acceptance shows that there is recognition across tiers, across colleges, to skill themselves, to certify themselves on the skills and be visible to the corporate. Like I said, we have started with banking and IT, but we will continue to add more industry and subject variants so that almost any degree holder, whether it's engineering or science or arts or commerce, is able to come to this platform, take a test that is relevant to them and get a job. That is our mission. Students that currently studying in a tier 3, tier 4 college or a city sometimes might not have as many opportunities in terms of campus placements like a tier 1 college or a city. So it actually, this kind of a platform helps them to get visibility. Maybe sitting in one corner of India, they could still take the test, get a good score, apply for a job anywhere in India, and then depending on the job preference and location, they might shift to that location as well. So it actually opens up a larger window of opportunity for students to apply post the NQBIS certification. A self-assessment capability with multiple attempts is something we're enabling so that the students can use this to practice and keep bettering their ability in a particular area, so that when it comes to a final year exam, they actually are, supposing they're taking this test in third year and final year, as I explained earlier, maybe they can get better by the time they take the final attempt at the end of the fourth year. In terms of in-center, TCS has the maximum coverage in terms of sector exam sectors in 670 plus cities and 6800 plus centers in 670 plus cities. Now, as an institution, right, what does that it means to you, right? While this is available for the students to buy directly from the portal, I would encourage the colleges to look at it in a more holistic manner. Don't leave it to students as a choice, because when you're looking to improve your placement and get as many jobs for your students as possible, it will be good for them to come onto this platform for them to take the test. Whether it is TCS or any other corporate, the more students get certified on this, the more chance they get to apply to more corporates, not only now, down the line as well. I talked about the fact that a lot of processes happen post getting the score, job application, selection, interview. Now, if you're actually buying this in bulk, because you're investing on behalf of the students, say a college is buying 500 licenses and you're distributing it to 500 students, then as a college, you can get visibility into these 500 students' performance in terms of whether they wrote the exam, how much score they scored, what all companies they've applied for, have they been shortlisted, selected, and it helps you to understand in terms of what further corrective action you can take for subsequent semester or for subsequent year. With large pool of corporates available, it's going to improve the job outcome for your students and hence your placement and a branding for you. Now, when you come to know of the student's performance, you can also look at different interventions you can do, right? We have industry honor certification courses as interventions. We have online programs as interventions. Now you could look at outside TCS ION and look at different online courses or books that you could create as interventions, right? So you can look at doing this like a group concept, right? Where you enroll 500 students, then bring some sort of a community concept where everyone is finding a way to motivate each other and learn through different online references and through your knowledge of what they are doing throughout the exam. Right? Last but not the least, because you are going to invest in bulk on behalf of the students, we're also looking at an attractive price on top of what is given as the discounted price in the platform. We can look at a discounted price when institutions are buying in bulk. So this is where I will stop and I will take up any questions coming from you. Team Shubhra, back to you.
Sure, Mani. Before I put up the questions to you, I just want to mention that I'm opening the poll for all the participants to give in their feedback to us to understand their opinion and reach out to them in future. And this poll will be open for the next 15 minutes. And meanwhile, we will start with the Q&A. So, Mani, I will start with the first question. So, one of the participants wants to know that will the mechanical engineer students like they can apply for the NQT exams?
Yes, as I said, we are doing this as an eligibility test for different degrees and different disciplines within those degrees. No restriction.
Okay, the next question is they want to know that can we charge NQT subscription fees to students at institute level, and that's completely with the college management, and do they have to get into some MOU for this?
Okay, so let us look at two parts. Now, if you are buying licenses in bulk, like I explained to you, then you have to go, you can actually go into the website, TCS Learning Hub website, and buy in bulk. Let us say you buy 500 licenses. Now, There are certain processes that you complete. All that is part of the platform. There is no separate documentation required. So you register as an institution, and then we approve your application, and then there is a you get approved as a distributor. Then you get provision to, because you paid for 500 licenses, you get a provision to generate 500 licenses, download it and share it to your students. Now this whole thing, there is no separate additional agreement or MOU required. Now subsequently, let us say you want to give this 500 licenses to your students. Now if you bought it, let us say at a discounted price, maybe you can pass on that benefit to your students, and you collect that money either as part of an NQT fees, as part of a placement fees, we leave it to you. So for that part, again, there is no intervention with the TCS. It's up to you how you recover, if you recover from the students.
That's great. One of the institute, one of the participant from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, wants to know that most of the students have TCS NQT scorecard, but not any communication for interview or details of the next step after getting this scorecard. So what should they do?
Okay. See, first, I think this is very important for all of the people in the webinar to understand. TCS NQT is a employability test, right? It is conducted by TCS IOL. This is on one side of it. Other side, TCS as a corporate will open up drives when they are hiring. For example, in October when they hired, they opened up a Ninja drive. Now they are, when they are hiring for off-campus hiring in February, they opened up off-campus hiring for 2019-20 students, pass out students. Now they're doing BPS hiring, they will open up another drive for them. So as a corporate, as and when they're hiring, they will open up specific job drives. As a candidate who has taken NQT, has to go and apply for the job. You are applying for a test here, TCS NQT. On this side, you're going applying for a job. You have to do both. Doing this will not automatically do this side. Applying and writing test is one action. Applying for a job, attending the interview and getting selected is another action with TCS as a corporate. So for a question, specific question after writing the test, assuming that you've applied for a job with TCS, if you're eligible and if you're meeting the eligibility criteria, they would have shortlisted you and called for an interview. That's how the process works.
That's great. One of the participants has a question that is the score acceptable for real estate and project management industry companies like Tata Projects or Tata Realty?
Like I said, most companies use cognitive ability as the differentiating factor when they are doing shortlisting or initial selection. So real estate kind of an industry or construction kind of industry or manufacturing kind of industry or power industry, this will still apply. Cognitive score is what will be relevant.
Okay, the next question is, Mani, that 2021 pass out batch students from 2021 pass out batch, are they eligible for this NQT test?
NQT test is open for freshers. The definition of fresher is anyone who is graduating next year, which is pre-final year, right? Or graduating this year, or graduated in the last 2 years. So if I'm talking about 2021, someone who's graduating in 22 is okay, 21 is okay, and 19-20 is okay. So these 4 years can apply for this. And they can be for any degree. Again, as I said, this is TCS NQT as an employability product. But if you're talking about TCS as a company, you have to look at specific eligibility criterion that TCS is putting in that particular drive. As and when they open a drive, they'll clearly tell who can apply in the drive.
Right. The next question is, Mani, that one of the students has appeared for NQT in February, but had selected the subject as basic computer skills in IT. Now, if that student wants to look for bank option, then should he has to appear for the NQT, the subject NQT with the banking subject?
See, again, as I said, it is a choice that they have to make. Supposing with the current, the score that they've got and the job role they're applying for is sufficient, they need not write it. But when they apply for a job, which is, say, for example, there is a financial analyst job. And for that financial analyst job, that company is looking for an in-depth expertise in financial derivatives or market analysis, right? Then they have to pick up that skill. So it is entirely dependent on their career aspiration and the specific requirements or skill set that that particular company is asking for. If current scores are sufficient, get a job using that. But when you start applying, you realize that this is not sufficient. You need more certification in the banking industry NQT for banking and subject NQT for financial markets and services. You might have to do it additionally. Again, completely dependent on your career aspiration and the corporate's requirement.
Okay. One of them wants to know that if the student has given the exam in the third year, and then can he be applicable for this exam in fourth year as well? And which of the scores will be valid, the first one and or the second one?
First question. He or she can appear in third year as well as fourth year. And for the second question, we consider the best score, not the latest score.
Right. Many questions are related to their students are given NQT in October and in Feb, and they have applied with the same email IDs and they have paid the fees also this time. So is there any next step portal for registrations for them?
No, they have to go and look at, like I said, for example, in February and March, there was a drive for 2019-20 graduates. So they have to look at a specific drive opening up in TCS. As and when it comes up, they can apply.
Okay. The next question is, Mani, most of the institutes wants to know that if they want, students want to get placed in TCS and they have already given industry, they have got industry IT programming score with the NQT score. So do they have to buy subject IT programming also in order to get a job in TCS? Their students?
See, I think somewhere it is getting mixed up. Industry NQT is for information technology as an industry concept. It is a basic awareness of the information technology industry. The subject NQT IT programming is checking the candidate's expertise in programming. It has programming related objective questions and programming related hands-on, where the student is expected to write code, compile, submit, and show that his or her code is working. Both are different, and TCS mandates subject NQT IT programming. Many other IT companies also ask for that. However, if you also additionally possess the industry NQT for information technology, it shows that you have got a broader understanding of how information technology industry operates. That's how we should look at it. Both are different.
Right. One of the institutes has mentioned that if their students want to prepare for TCS NQT, how they can prepare and from where they can. Like, is there any sample test or any information or the course or something related to that so that they can prepare for it?
Yeah, one of the sad things for me is that as much as we put information outside, people don't go through it at all. We have got about 25 questions, FAQs, frequently asked questions. It takes about 15 minutes for someone to go through all that because we have thought through what all questions students might get and we have tried to answer them. People don't go through that. And the same NQT, that is National Qualifier Test product page, there is a sample link as well, sample test link. When they click that, for different NQT variants, there are sample papers available. that actually has sample questions in terms of what type of questions will come in different areas, right? So for someone who is wanting to understand how or what type of questions will come, that is a sample test is a place to go. Someone wants to prepare for this, there are a lot of online material available, free and paid. You can do that. There is a book by Wiley, which is actually called TCS National Qualifier Test. It's a printed book. Not sure how many of you have seen it. That focuses on helping the students prepare for the cognitive test, right? So that is something you could look at. It's about 400 rupees or so. So we are not promoting that book as such, but it is available. I've come across this book when one of the students referred that to me. Hence, I know that I'm sharing it with all of you. So explore the, but as I said, there are a lot of free material available as well. So it is just about someone putting their mind and searching and then passing that knowledge to rest of the students. In case if you're an institution, for example, and if you're running the placement department, you can ask some students to search and collate some 8 to 10 useful links, maybe some free and some paid, and then share it with all your students. Then let the students decide which free link is good, which paid link is good, let them go and explore. But there are tons of material available to prepare. One example I gave you is this Wiley book.
Sure, Mani. Like most of the institutes have the query that if the students are more interested in getting placed in TCS or the top corporate. So is there any minimum marks or how much marks are they required to get a call from TCS or from the corporates?
Unfortunately, I'll not be able to answer that because each corporate has their own eligibility criteria based on what type of degree they're hiring, what type of roles they're hiring for. So they could change that criterion based on their corporate HR policy. Whether it was TCS or Flipkart or L&T or Reliance, I will not know what their requirements are. However, typically if you are in the range of about 70% and above, your chances are high.
Sure, Manu. So next question is, when is the next NQT test for freshers and in which month it will come?
See, the one we are doing right now is in May. And after that, we'll finalize the date. It will be somewhere in August, September, but we'll finalize the date and let you know. It will be, our plan is to do this every 3-4 months.
Institutes wants to know, can their students give tests from home with all proctored methods by TCS because of the pandemic situations right now?
Yes, it's a very good question. We are making this test available both in remote, which is remote assessment at home model, right? And an in-center model. Now, for someone to take the exam at home, they need a good working computer with strong internet, with working web camera, and a browser, and a Windows operating system, right? Windows or Ubuntu. Now, we also do something like an infrastructure readiness check. I encourage all the students to participate in it and make sure that they are comfortable launching the exam. See, this is not something where you go to a website and then browse something, right? This is actually a software which we call as a launcher, right? So you have to download that, launch it, log in, see the question paper, and make sure that in a mock or trial mode, you're comfortable end to end. We give that opportunity upfront before the exam for all students to participate in it. Again, unfortunately, I have seen hardly 40% of the students participate. Remaining 60% think they know everything. They can come on the exam day and take the exam. But believe me, 90% of them can't even launch the exam. The 40% who actually participated in it, almost 100% of them can launch the exam. So the difference is participating in the mock test that you are being provided upfront, participating in it and getting comfortable with it so that on the exam day, you're not having any launch issues. Now, in any remote exam, proctoring is a challenge. Hence, what we have done is we have put infrastructure at our end to make sure that entire 3-hour exam is recorded. Every second, every nanosecond is getting recorded. Say if I'm a candidate like this, I'm looking at this, my face will be recorded as not seen, right? So there is a human proctor where these videos are watched by human proctors who look at any abnormal behavior from the candidate in taking the exam. There is artificial intelligence, machine learning driven algorithm that analyze these video feeds and flag these cases as candidates who have not taken the exam in a free and fair manner. Such candidates are blacklisted and their scores will not be published, and they cannot write the exam for 1 year, and they cannot apply to TCS or any other corporate as well. So there is lot of proctoring, monitoring, AML checks being done to make sure that the candidates take this exam in a manner they will do at the hall. Just because of the fact that the candidates could not travel to a center in pandemic, they're extending this privilege, and we hope that the students use this privilege in the right manner. Anyone misusing it will be caught, and we have, even last exam when we did, we have actually debarred about 1,000 candidates for doing this exam in a compromised manner, not in a free manner, in a fair manner, right? So I would strongly advise the students taking this exam in a remote mode to make sure that they assume that they are sitting in an exam hall and take the exam, as simple as that. If there is a doubt on whether this is allowed or not allowed, ask yourself, can I do this in the exam hall? The answer is no, you can't do it now. That's all. There is no ifs and buts.
Okay, that's great, Mani. I think that will clarify their doubt. The next question is that some of students who are in the third year, and if they give the exam, so is there should be, and they want to appear again, so there should be a gap of 6 months for one TCS NQT to the second TCS NQT they are giving, or how will the eligibility will be 6 months, the gap of 6 months, or if they can appear next time also?
See, from a exam conduct perspective, we are conducting every 3 months and we are giving them the best score. However, certain corporates might have some eligibility rules that you can't take 2 exams so close. So TCS has that criterion that it has to have 6 months apart. So for someone who's interested in a TCS career, I would say space your exam 6 months apart. But it is entirely based on the corporate's restriction on that. But from our side, we conduct exam every 3 months, and whatever is the best score, we give that to the candidate.
Okay. The mechanical domain questions are coming up, Mani. So I will just club 2-3 questions and ask, say for Tata Power or Tata Steel, which are more or less related to mechanical domain, will this test be useful? And second part of it is, are there any specific subjects selection option available for the mechanical engineering students of their institute for this NQT exam?
The first part I already answered. I'm not going to answer it again. The second part of your question, right now, there are no manufacturing specific variants. We will come up shortly. We will, as part of the subsequent NQT, we'll identify more industry specific variants that are on the automotive and manufacturing and retail as well.
Okay. One of the questions is, how is the total marks calculated, and it is mandatory to give all the 3 exams? I don't know which 3 exams they're talking about. And what if a student doesn't score good in programming, and how does it will affect the total marks?
First of all, from a TCS NQT as an eligibility test, while you're buying a bundle, You are being subscribed to three individual products. You will write these exams separately and you will get a score. So you'll have a scorecard for cognitive, you'll have a scorecard for programming, and you'll have a report for attitude alignment, right? Or you've written additionally an industry NQT for information technology, you'll have a score for that as well. There is no concept of combining all the scores and giving one mammoth total score. There is no concept, right? Now coming to the question whether programming will impact, again, that depends on how TCS is applying its eligibility criteria. Now TCS as a company has told, for all IT hiring, I will mandate cognitive and programming. How much percentage they will give, weightage they will give for cognitive, how much they will give for programming, is there a minimum cutoff for cognitive, minimum cutoff for programming, I do not know. And none of us will know, because that is part of the HR policy and HR selection criteria. It will not be available in public domain.
Right.
So if you are a candidate interested in a TCS job, all you can do is do your best. Do your best to score, as I said, maybe 70% is about a minimum. Right? But if you're really, really keen on getting a TCS job, then you have to figure out a way to get even 95% plus, 90% plus. Then your chances are extremely high.
Okay, Mani, one of the questions have come that some of the students are interested in giving TCS NQT, but they have some backlogs in 2-3 papers. So can those students give the exam, give this TCS NQT?
Again, as I said, I cannot answer TCS related eligibility, right? For TCS NQT as an employability test, if you want to take it today with even your backlog or arrears, yeah, we allow, because you're practicing it and you might clear the arrear 3 months from now and you might get a better NQT score next time. So we are not stopping. However, let us say you take that NQT exam now, you get 95%. You go and apply for a job in L&T. L&T says backlog is not allowed, which means that you cannot use that score. So it is not about me restricting, but about a corporate telling what their eligibility criteria is. Same way for TCS. If TCS says backlog is not allowed, then you cannot apply to TCS. You might have to clear your backlog. So in summary, I am allowing you to take the test so that you can certify your knowledge. With that knowledge, when you apply to a corporate, that corporate will decide whether you're eligible for that job or not. Whether it is TCS or L&T or Flipkart or any other company, their eligibility criterion decides whether you can apply to them or not. Supposing you are not eligible, you have to pick a job that you are eligible for or overcome the eligibility criteria or meet the eligibility criteria.
Sure, Mani. So for this proctored exam, they want to know that is the pen and paper allowed for the students to do some rough work?
We strongly discourage you to do that, because when you're taking this exam in a remote assessment model, right, it is very difficult for a machine. I told you AML algorithm, right? It is very difficult for that machine to figure out, for example, whether when you look down like this, whether you're looking at your mobile or you're doing home, you're doing a rough work, right? So the machine will mark as a potential unfair means, right? So to avoid that, we have created two tools in the online platform. It's, and one tool is a calculator. So for some of the questions that need a calculation, you use online calculator. So you just look at the screen like this and you do it. You're not looking down, you're looking actually at the screen, right? So use the calculator. Second is, there is a rough work there. So maybe you can use rough work there. So I would advise that as much as possible, do not use any rough work outside what is allowed in terms of the rough area within the computer and the calculator.
Okay. The institute wants to know the bulk registration, like, do you have institutions bulk registrations?
Yes, that's what I spoke about, that while the individual product is available for purchase on our website for the students, we are looking at giving a discounted price for bulk purchase by the institutions. So you should show that page, move to that page. So this is the page, right, where institutions can go and say, check, right? We can even share this link as part of the chat window. Share this link as part of the chat window, Himshida.
So you
can click that link, and there you can see all the details in terms of what it is and how you can benefit from this NQT initiative. And you can also register yourself as an institution. So we'll come, once you register there, we will work with you to onboard you as a distributor. One thing is that the exam is, registrations are closing by April 21st, 6 days from now. So if you're keen on this discounted bulk discount model, I would encourage you to do it maybe today, tomorrow, so that you have time to give this license to your students.
I have done again. I have just put the link in the chat window once again for the institutes to have a look at the page. The next question is, Mani, they want to know a few companies that have partnered or are looking at considering NQT. I think you have already covered that in the PPT.
Yeah, these are a representative list of companies that have partnered with us now. Now we are working with them to post their fresher jobs. Some of them have told that their fresher jobs are not immediate. They are not an immediate need, so we are working with them to post their jobs. But as a partner, they've said that they are okay to hire based on NQT score. There are 100 of them as of now, and this list will keep growing.
Right. The next question is, Mani, like what is the minimum salary package offered by corporates through this TCS and job listing platform if the students apply through that?
No, there is no minimum that that I am seeing. It is typically say about 10 to 15K per month, right? So that is where the starting salary could be. And it could go as high as maybe 50, 60K per month. But again, it's completely based on the corporate and the job role. So it will vary anywhere from say 15K to 60K per month.
Right. One of the questions is, Mani, like the students have applied for jobs using their NQT scores. They have secured 70% or more, and they have published their profile in the My Profile section also. But still, they are not receiving any emails regarding the selection process. So, any next steps for the same?
No, there is no next step for them right now. If they have already completed their digital profile and they have applied for the job, we are working with the companies to make sure that the companies are shortlisting the suitable candidates and they're hiring them. So wherever they are eligible for the job, they'll hear from TCS ION or from the company in the next couple of weeks.
That's great. The next question is there any like a helpline number or where they can contact or an email ID? Because during the test, during the NQT test, if the students face any problems, so it can be of help to them if they are taking the exams from their homes.
First of all, for any questions related to this before the exam, they can write to this ID seen on the screen, info@tcsionhub.com. If they are having exam challenges during the exam, they would use a live chat. But as I said, if someone has completed the dry run check, infrastructure readiness check, or the dry run check, or the mock test, they should face less number of problems or no problems. And supposing, you need to understand that this is an internet-based test. So at the time of taking the exam, if your internet goes down, then you have to find a way to connect your internet. Either your Wi-Fi comes up or you use your mobile as a hotspot and you bring internet connectivity to your laptop. Then once you enable internet connectivity, then you have to launch the exam again, it will start. Up to 10 minutes, you will not lose time. But if you lose because of power or internet more than 10 minutes, then you will start losing time in the exam itself. So you have to find a way to make sure that you have sufficient power and sufficient internet connectivity. And if you're not sure, you can always opt for an in-center exam.
Okay. The next question says, what is the one? Like, if the institutes are getting into MOU, say, then how many job opportunities TCS IN is committed to the institute?
See, we are not committing in terms of interviews or placement percentages, anything like that. We are telling that this is a portal where we are bringing corporate partners. So as and when those jobs are posted, they'll apply for it. There is no commitment from TCS IN on this. But our goal, as I said, is to bring a very large number of corporates so that you'll be able to place your students. That is our number one priority, to bring more number of corporates and more number of jobs from these corporates. That is what our focus will be. We have done so far about 100 now, but we believe that is not sufficient. We will definitely keep increasing the number. As I said, before end of the year, our mission is to have at least 1,000 corporates in the platform. And even if each corporate is posting 5 jobs, should have 5,000 jobs in the platform. That is what we are targeting.
Right, Pani. One of the questions is that what is the pattern for the TCS NQT exam?
They have to go to the portal and see. If they go to learninghub.tcsin.com, then they will see, they can search for NQT as a product. They can go and see all the details there.
Okay. The next question is that when these results will be published for TCS NQT for this May exam?
See, first we have to make sure that the registration process closes so that we know the exact number of candidates writing the exam. Post it, we'll be able to publish the results schedule. It'll take at least a couple of weeks minimum.
Okay. One of the questions is some of the students, if they have scored in 12th, say less than 60%, so are they eligible to appear for this TCS NQT? 12th is one of the eligibility criteria for this exam or not? 12th scores exam.
I'm repeating for the third or fourth time. TCS NQT as a job employment test, there is no criterion based on your marks. As long as you are a graduate in a pre-final or final year, you can apply for this employability readiness test. When you go and apply for a job in a corporate, that corporate eligibility rules will apply.
So thank you very much, Mani, for your time.
Thank you. And thank you for taking the time out to spend the evening with us. It was nice talking to all of you. Thank you.